गुड मॉर्निंग डियर कैडेट्स. सो एज यूजुअल वी आर ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ मोशन, टाइम एंड स्पीड. ओके, सो जस्ट सी स्टडे ओनली आई इंट्रोड्यूस यू द टॉपिक्स. ओके, हाउ मेनी थिंग्स आर इंक्लूडेड इन दिस यूनिट. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द मेजरमेंट ऑफ टाइम. So as you know, just see, measurement of time is very important. Okay, suppose you want to go from Bijapur to Bengaluru. Okay, and suppose two fellow are there. One fellow went by a flight, other fellow by four wheeler. So now who will reach first? The fellow who went by a flight, that will be reach early there. So try to understand, that is the what to say qualitative measurement, but how much fast he has reached Bengaluru. Okay, so the difference of time should be there or not? So the difference of time can be measured with the help of some devices, and those devices are known as time measuring devices. So just try to understand, that means the time measuring devices are called clocks or watches. Okay, so just see the present era time measuring devices and ancient days time measuring devices are entirely different. In olden days, people were using the water clock, sand clock for measuring the time. Nowadays, what is there? Nowadays, you can understand digital clock. Then what is there? Just see, stopwatch, table clock, wall clock, digital clock, so many types of. Now just see, fitness band, just try to understand, there also watches are there. Now such type of watches are there which can measure our heartbeat also. So the meaning of this one is, there is a revolution in the time measuring devices. Okay, now try to understand. Of course, olden days, of course, water clock and sand clocks were used. But try to understand, the main source of time measuring devices were the movement of sun and moon. Okay, are you getting my point or not? Very easily, just see, when the sun is just above our head, that is noon time, before that one, before noon, after that, afternoon, like that people were understanding the time. Okay, nowadays there is no such kind of problem. Even nanosecond can be measured with efficiency. Okay, so let us have more idea about the stopwatch. Okay, so dear cadets, let us have the measurement of time using stopwatch. So just see, stopwatches are used for the measurement of time interval accurately between occurrences of events. Today they are provided in almost all the mobiles. So just see another points of stopwatch.
It is used to measure short-term intervals in laboratories, pulse rate of human beings, time lapsed in various events such as athletic events, etc.
Okay, so dear cadets, these are the various and common uses of stop clock. How much important stop clock is there nowadays? For the preparation of PPT, you are keeping the stopwatch only. Okay, not only this one, so many competitions are there, so many competition will be held in the school in near future, and all will be completed with the help of stopwatches only. Okay,
many events in nature repeat themselves after finite time intervals, like the sun rises every day in the morning. The time interval lapsed between two consecutive sunrises is called a day.
Okay, so as I told you, for the measurement of time, the sun and moon movement is very important. So that is only mentioned. The sun rises every day in the morning, and the time interval between two consecutive sunrises is called a day. Okay?
Time interval between one new moon and the next is called a month. Time taken by the earth to complete one revolution around the sun is called a year.
Okay, so dear cadets, just see the time interval between two sunrises, that is called day. Similarly, time interval between one new moon and the next is called a month. Okay, so just see 15 days, what is there? Full moon night. Phir next 15 days, what is there? Dark nights are there. So here, what is there? The time interval between two new moon is called the month. And ancient peoples, they were using this one only. They were only considering this one as a 1 month, 1 day, 1 year. The time taken by the earth to complete one revolution around the sun is called a year. The time taken by the earth to complete one revolution around the sun is called a year. Okay. So as you know, earth revolve around the sun. So how much time it is taking to complete one revolution? That is 365 days, and that is only called the year.
Time intervals shorter than a day can be measured by A. the sun's position, B. the moon's position, C. the star's position, D. clocks and watches.
So just see, the time intervals shorter than a day can be measured by using the sun's position, the moon's position, the star's position, clocks and watches. See the answer.
The correct option is D.
The duration of a day is 24 hours. Time interval shorter than a day can be measured by using clocks and watches, as these are usually calibrated for 12 hours. Okay.
Let's know about the story of the pendulum clock. Nope. Galileo Galilei observed the to and fro movement of a lamp suspended from a ceiling through a chain. He observed that his pulse beats the same number of times in the interval during which the lamp completes its one oscillation.
Okay, so just try to understand pendulum clock. The history traced back to the pendulum clock with the Galileo Galilei. He observed that his pulse beats the same number of time in the interval during which the lamp completes its one oscillation. Okay, so just see the pendulum clock, how he discovered.
After conducting various experiments, he concluded that the pendulum of a given length always completes its one oscillation in the same period of time. This observation resulted in the development of pendulum clocks.
So, dear cadets, he experimented with the several pendulums for the verification of his observation. He noticed that the pendulum of a given length always complete its one oscillation in the same time. Just see, this is pendulum. So how much time it will take to come this side, same time it will take to that side. We'll tell you what is the meaning of one oscillation and all those things. Just theoretical aspect, just you note down. This observation resulted in the development of pendulum clocks.
The better versions of pendulum clocks were winding clocks and wrist watches.
Okay.
Let's now study about the simple pendulum. Like pendulum clock, simple pendulum also works on the periodic motion. It consists of a small metallic ball or a mass that is attached to a fixed point by the means of a thread. The upper end of the thread is fixed. The small metallic ball or mass attached to the thread is called the bob of the pendulum. When the bob of the pendulum is released after taking it to one extreme side, it begins to move to and fro. The to and fro motion of the pendulum is known as oscillatory motion. Here, when the bob of the pendulum moves from position 1 to position 3 via position 2 and then back to position 1, then it is said to complete one oscillation.
Listen here, cadet. That is very important thing. The to and fro motion of the pendulum is known as oscillatory motion. What is the name of this one? Oscillatory motion. To and fro. Pendulum is said to have completed one oscillation when its bob starting from position 1. Just see. First, it will go here. Suppose you are pushing from this side to this side. So it will go to the 2. From 2 to 3. Again it will come to 1. 1 to 3. 3 to 3 to 1 back. So this is equal to 1 oscillation. So when its bob starting from position 1 moves to 2. 2 to 3 and back to 1. This is equal to 1 oscillation. Okay. So the meaning of one oscillation equal to 1 to 2, then 2 to 1, 1 to 3, 3 to 1. Are you getting my point or not? We can simplify this one. 1 to, suppose I am pushing from this side. So 1 to 2, 2 to 1, 1 to 3, 3 to 1. Okay, that is equal to one oscillation. Means from where you have pushed. This is the mean position. One position is the mean position. It has to come back on the same position. Then it is equal to one oscillation.
Here we can see the mean and extreme positions of the pendulum. In the above picture, we can see one mean position and two extreme positions. The time taken by the bob to complete one oscillation is called its time period.
So just try to understand. Other than mean position, whatever position bob is acquiring, that is extreme position. The time taken by the bob to complete one oscillation is called the time period. Means mean position to this extreme position, extreme position back to mean position to extreme position to back to the mean position. That is equal to one oscillation and time completed to time taken by the bob to complete one oscillation is called time period.
Frequency of oscillation is defined as the number of oscillations in 1 second. Amplitude is the maximum displacement of the bob from its mean position.
So it is the maximum displacement of the bob of the pendulum from its mean position. That is known as maximum displacement. Mean position, this is this side, this is amplitude. And what is the frequency? The number of oscillation per second. In 1 second, how many oscillation bob is completing? That is known as frequency.
The SI unit of time is second.
So dear cadets, in this way almost today's duration is completed. Today I am not giving you very big questions. Just see the simple question I am giving you. Draw the diagram of pendulum. Simple pendulum. Okay. So bob and all those things you have to sow. What is the oscillation? Simple question. What is time period? What is the frequency of oscillation? What is amplitude? That those things you can write. Not only this one. Whatever one word means explanation today I have shown, those things should also be written. Let it be extra. They may not come under any question. But for the sake of your knowledge, those things should be written. But the answer of these questions must be there. Okay? Thank you. Tomorrow we'll teach you the time and so many things about the time. Today I taught measurement of time. Tomorrow what is there? Time, unit, speed, so many things are there. Okay? Thank you.